Welcome to another meal. Decided to splurge and just go out to eat for lunch. So I went to Zips and got a root beer. They have mug root beer there and it's so freaking good when it's good. It always tastes like that fountain. I mean that draft style, like if it's made in the basement or something. All right, so I got some tartar sauce, some fry sauce. If you guys have never ate Zips, it originated in Washington. I believe the first one was like Tri-Cities, Washington. But they used to print like the old menu on here and stuff. But now it's funny because over the years, now it's just like fake print. But it used to say like what stuff would cost way back then, like when it opened. I think it opened in 19... Well, it says it's over 70 years. So what does that mean? Let's do math. 70 years. So we take 24. That would take us down to 2000. Then we take another 30. That takes us to 70. Then we take that 6 that we're missing. It takes us 19... 64. Someone get a calculator. It comes with cocktail sauce. I have some in my fridge. I'm gonna taste this, so if it's not good, I'll just go get the Skipper's brand. It smells good. And I got the shrimp basket. They're known for, they have burgers and stuff, and it's all like, they like make, you know, they don't have it, like they'll make it like right when you get there. You have to wait a minute in the drive through. But they have like really good chicken strip baskets. They have crinkle fries. A lot of people don't like these. They're good fries though. They have onion rings, like jalapeno poppers. Sometimes they'll have cheese tots, tater tot cheese with cheese like inside too. Those are good. They have a really good fish and chip basket for like an old fast food place. They do good fish there, you know? Like, I mean, a lot of people might go there. Some people are picky when it comes to fish and stuff. Their fried shrimps are really good. I love getting this. Oh, man. I was hungry. Been kind of sick the last few days. Oh, not really like bad sick, but something gave me really low energy and low appetite. And I'm getting my appetite back now. These are good. Anybody eat the tails? I know a lot of people do. When I was a kid, I just eat the whole thing. I'm gonna feel like my appetite is kind of like this right now, but this is hitting the spot. Really meaty. Their sauces are amazing too. They have a fry sauce and they don't hold back. They don't charge extra. Man, they like, you have so much that like you won't even be able to eat it all. You'll save it in the fridge. You'll end up throwing it away and feel bad. And like, there's times I'm like, don't give me so much sauce. But it's just kind of cool because so many places, you know, they charge for the sauce. Like even if you're getting like chicken nuggets at McDonald's. Actually, I don't know for sure, but like I feel like every time I go there and they're like, well, what sauce do you want? And you're like, for your nuggets, and I'll be like, sweet and sour. I don't know if they charge you for that, if that's included in the meal. But I remember back in the day, you could just get sauces. You could add them on. Never cost money. The tartar sauce is amazing. It's so good. And their food is slightly more expensive than like your normal place. Everywhere's expensive nowadays though, but like this shrimp basket. Well, I ate like three already, maybe four, but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It looks like it comes with probably 14 or 15 shrimps. Oh my God, it's so good. The freaking root beer. Let me know in the comments if you guys like root beer. Some people don't like it. You gotta watch out for those types of people, you know? It's a red flag. It's almost better with the tartar sauce. Wow. They give you a little lemon. I think I said the price of this. I'm not sure, but I think I just said it. $9.99. Their burgers are really good too. And it's one of the places where you can like order, for example, the type of place it is, fast food it is. You can get cheddar on your burger instead of, you know, just American cheese. Which some people love that, you know. The shrimp is really the star of the show. I'm not huge into fries. I've never really finished my fries my whole life. And honestly, it's one of those, you know, fried foods aren't good for us, the fried oils or whatever, but damn, they taste good. But fries, I'm kind of glad I stay away from them. It's so good. And they're like butterfly too. So they're like nice, flat, fat piece of meat. Super good. Oops. Like a really crispy piece of fry. Oh my God, it's like the way that root beer hits is so good. I need to shave soon because you get to that point where you're eating, you have to go with your mustache and put it in. You have to wash your face after you're done eating, otherwise you'll have stuff here. Damn, it's hitting the spot. Well, probably not the best day to go out to eat because I feel like I'm going to go out to eat twice today because, you know, my daughter has a school thing going on where she does cheerleading and it's like her first game she gets to cheer for in middle school, and then those always make for a really tight scheduled evening. And there's just almost no time to like eat and have us all eat together. So I make her lunch a little bigger. She has snacks and can get it filled up nice and good. Excuse me. And then what I'll do is once the whole thing's done, we'll go through a drive-thru or we'll go to a sit-down restaurant, depending on how much energy everyone has. But I This is a nice pick-me-up. I needed this. My wife was hungry, and I was getting hungry, and we both realized we're really hungry. And I was going to make something, but I was like, you know what? I'm just going to treat us because if I go make something and do all that, it's just going to be a little more work than I want to do for how I've been feeling all week. And sometimes you just need to eat right away. Man, they have a clean fryer there too. And some of the other locations, the Zips around here, I've been to, are really good too. They all vary a little bit. Some of them will carry stuff that others don't. And they also have, oh, I found it, guys. So I found, actually under this is the old menu stuff. It's kind of neat, look at excuse me. It's gonna be all backwards and stuff, but see, it says like root beer. I'll just read it to you guys. Coffee, always fresh, 10 cents. Hot chocolate and cream, 15 cents. Milk, 13 cents. Tea, 10 to 20 cents. Probably on the type of tea you're getting. Pints, 30 cents. I wonder if they sold beer at that time. Quarts, I think they just measured, like more, you know, standardized and used those words for everything. Root beer, a gallon for 60 cents. That's awesome. And I've been to the, so been to the original locations too. I grew up in the Tri-Cities, and I'm, anybody who's ever passed through like Ritzville, Washington has ate at their Zips. I've had some bad food there before though. That's a main tourist stop, that you stop at. It's like one of the main stops and you get gas, really small town. And you know, they're just serving lots of people. And it's just almost like over, and then they have slow times too. So it's just really hard for them to have consistency. And I actually haven't been back to that one in since the last bad experience, because it was, everything was so bad. And then when I asked them to fix something, they just like refused to because they were so busy. And I said, okay. And I just left. Didn't make a big deal about it at all. But Zips is usually really, really good. Shrimp, dip, swallow, root beer. It's so good. And I'm so full already. I have two shrimpies left. And I feel like I wasted the fries. I don't know how I could save them and offer them to my kids when they're home later, but I feel like it's just unhealthy for them. They need to eat better than just some old cold fries as a snack, you know? Oh. Let me know in the comments. If you guys like shrimp, some people don't. Some people don't even eat meat, you know, of any kind, or fish. But I have some gift cards for Red Lobster too, so I'm gonna make a video for there. It used to be my favorite place. Growing up, I'd go there all the time for my birthdays and stuff. And my neighbor gave me two $50 gift cards. They had asked if I would help get their son to school. They're literally my one house in between us, you know, like, and really nice people. And I was like, of course, I'm already going there. Like, and they just were like so kind. Like, if I'm doing them a huge favor, I was like, I insisted. I was like, I'm happy to. Like, I'm one of those people that I tell people this, like, when they get neighbors and stuff, I'm like, the very best thing you can do is introduce yourself to your neighbors, say hi to your neighbors, wave at your neighbors. No matter what, love thy neighbor. And it's really important, because you think the easier route is to like just kind of ignore people. Sometimes a lot of people don't want to meet the people they live right next to and stuff, but that's where community comes from. And it's a little bit of work to say hi and stuff like that, but man, these people will have your back, you know, and then you feel like you have a real sense of community. And when you don't, when you're like, I'll just avoid it, it's way worse. It's way worse. You still have to deal with your neighbors, trust me. So it's a little piece of advice. I'm doing it. Last shrimpy. No cocktail. Yeah, so I'm gonna do a Red Lobster one. I'll do a video for that. But $250 gift cards, and they have like all sorts of specials running right now. I haven't been in a couple years, but what I used to get was like that captain's platter. I don't know if everybody used to, they probably still have it. Like, I don't know exactly what it's called. It was that big ass one, and it was like, I'd get it on my birthday. It was like $27.50, probably more expensive now, but it had like, you know, it had like every kind of shrimp, a little bit of every kind. And it has like a little bit of the crab legs or stuff like that. It was the plate that had like a little bit of everything, the tail, the little steak. That's how I remember it in my head, but I'm excited to go. Let me know, if you guys were going to Red Lobster, do you kind of dress up to go there? Or do you consider it like the, just like the Applebee's of seafood, you know? I also went to Olive Garden a while ago for the first time in so many years. And it was really fun. What's fun sometimes though is like these restaurants can be really, really affordable if you're just like really hungry. I noticed Red Lobster, they do the soup, salad, and endless biscuits. Endless soup, salad, and biscuits for $11.99. It's like, if me and my wife went for lunch, that's so cheap. That's like, reminds me of like when we first started dating, like, and we'd know, like, we'd be like, dang, we're gonna spend $30 to $40 on this meal, and it seemed like a lot. And now inflation and the economy, it's everything's a different view now, you know, there's all different perspective. Thanks so much for watching, you guys. If you get the chance to try Zips, give it a shot. Let me know what you think. If you've tried it before, let me know where and what you guys think. If you don't like it, let me know why.